Hello everyone, welcome back to English video lessons. I am glad to meet you all through this video class. How are you my dear children? I hope you are all doing well. It gives me immense pleasure that you my dear children using these classes effectively. Am I right? Okay, fine. Today we are going to enjoy the beauty of the poem Our Casuarina Tree written by Torudet. Come on, tell me the title. Our Casuarina Tree. Our Casuarina Tree was written by Torudet. Before we catch the lines of the poem, let me give you the glimpses of the poetess Torudet. This introduction will be very useful to understand this poem. This will serve as a good background to this poem, The Casuarina Tree. Torudet, 1856-1877, was a Bengali poet from the Indian subcontinent who wrote in English and French. Torudet was born in 1856 and died in 1877. She belonged to Bengal in India. She produced her works in English and French. She was the third daughter of the family. There were three children in the family. They were Arju, Aru and Toru. Toru was the youngest one. Arju, the eldest one, died at the age of 14 due to some sickness. Aru died at the age of 23 due to pulmonary tuberculosis. The Dutt family was a family of distinguished intellectuals and poets. Distinguished means very successful. Intellectuals means the persons who have high mental power. So it was a family of poets and successful intellectuals. She also had the advantage of being taught by excellent English tutors at home and later on of the long stay in Europe and England. Tutor means a private teacher who teaches one or two children. So she had the benefit of being taught by excellent English tutor when she was in India and later on when she was in Europe and England. Toru, with all her exposure to and involvement in Western life and culture, loved the land of her birth and remained thoroughly Indian in her consciousness and sensibility. Consciousness means a person's awareness. Sensibility means aesthetic influence. Though she was exposed to Western life and culture, she loved her motherland and remained Indian in her mind and thoughts. Besides her well-known collection of poems with the title Ancient Ballads and Legends of Hindustan in 1882, she has to her credit a volume of poems in French titled Sheep Gleaned in French Fields in 1875. The title of the well-known collection of poems in English is Ancient Ballads and Legends of Hindustan, and the title of the well-known collection of poems in French is Sheep Gleaned in French Fields. Our Casuarina Tree, the most well-known of Toru's poems, was included in her miscellaneous poems. Toru also died young at the age of 21 in 1877 due to tuberculosis. The death of her siblings affected a lot, very deeply. She expressed her grief and loneliness in the poem, Our Casuarina Tree. Enough introduction we had about Toru's death. Now let's get into the poem, Our Casuarina Tree.
Come on children, tell me the names of the trees that we have around us. Yes, many trees are there. Neem tree, mango tree, banyan tree, peepal tree, gulmohar tree, etc. When we have these trees in our garden, we are so happy to play in their shades, climb on the trees, stone their fruits, swing in the branches of the trees. Isn't it? Really, they are cheerful moments. When we are away from these trees, we can't forget those pleasant days spent under the tree. Am I right? For example, you visit your school after several years. When you cross the gulmohar tree at the entrance, cheerful memories of your childhood fill your mind. You remember how you used to play, used to sit and write some tests, used to participate in competitions in the shades of the tree. Likewise, the poetess Torudet, when she was away from the tree, remembers the casuarina tree and involves herself in the nostalgic memories of her happy childhood spent with her siblings. Our Casuarina Tree. In this poem, Torudet celebrates a huge tree, the casuarina tree, that belonged to her big garden house at Rambagan in her childhood in India. During her stay in France, she fondly remembers the casuarina tree and associates the tree with the happiness of her childhood and the memory of her dead siblings, Abju and Aru, with whom she played beneath the tree. So it is not an ordinary tree, but rather a part of her life, an integral part of her childhood shared with her siblings. Through the use of the word our in the poem's title, the poet's perspective is more than merely her own. The title implies that she thinks of the tree as not simply hers, but as belonging to others too. So the title is Our Casuarina Tree.
Our Casuarina Tree. The first half of the first stanza of the poem is given here. There is a casuarina tree in the poet's garden. The poem begins with a description of this casuarina tree. A creeper, like a huge python, is winding itself around the rough trunk of the casuarina tree. Python means a huge snake. Rugged trunk means rough trunk of the tree. The strong hold of the creeper has created some deep lines and marks on the tree. Indented deep with scars means deep lines and marks on the tree. It goes up to the top of the tree, almost touching the stars in the sky. Summit means top. The creeper climbs on the tree and embraces the tree very tightly. No other tree except this casuarina tree can stand in the strong hold of the creeper. This shows the strength and courage of the tree, which is standing tall and bravely, gallantly, bravely. In the first line, we can see two figures of speech. One is zoomorphism, the other one is simile. Zoomorphism is a thing is spoken in animal terms. Here, the creeper is said as a huge python. And simile is two things are compared. Here, the creeper is compared to a python. So, two figures of speech are applied in the first line. The second half of the first stanza is displayed here. The giant is the casuarina tree. The creeper is a scarf to the tree. The giant tree, the big tree, wears the climber as a scarf. Here the figure of speech personification is applied. The tree wears the creeper as a scarf like a human being. The flowers in the tree are in crimson clusters. Crimson clusters means deep red bunches, hanging among all the boughs of the tree. Boughs means branches. The bright and beautiful hedonic appearance of the garden attracts the bees and birds to the garden. So the bees and birds gathered around the tree hail the day. Hail the day means welcome the day and make the day pleasant. And often at night, oft means often. And often at night, the garden is overflown with the sweet, endless song of the birds sung from the dark side of the garden. While men are taking rest, repose means rest. While men are taking rest, the garden is jubilant with the song of the birds. This stanza gives the appearance of the casuarina tree. Now we'll see the first half of the second stanza. A lovely early morning scene is picturized here. At dawn, dawn means early morning. At dawn, when the poet opens her casement, casement means window, she is delighted to see the casuarina tree. She is happy to see the casuarina tree through the window. Sometimes, mostly in winter, on the crest of the tree, crest means top of the tree, a grey baboon, baboon means a large monkey, like a statue, sitting alone and watching the sunrise. Here the figure of speech simile is applied. The grey baboon is compared to a statue. It sits alone like a statue. In the lower boughs, boughs means branches, is peony offspring. Peony means small. Offspring means younger ones, leaping and playing on the tree. Leaping means jumping. The younger ones are jumping from one branch to another branch. In these lines, the tree is presented with the animals very beautifully. Now, second half of the second stanza. These few lines present a cooling environment. Far and near. Far and near means here and there. The kokilas. Kokilas means birds similar to the cuckoo. With their sweet songs, hail the day. Hail the day means praise the day and make the day cheerful. The sleepy cows wend. Wend means move to their pastures. Pastures means grazeland. There is a beautiful and vast water tank by the hoh tree. Hoh tree means tree which is covered with the snow. The shadow of the tree appears to fall on the huge water tank. The water lilies spring everywhere in the pond like snow and moss. Again, the poetess applied simile in the line. Water lilies are compared to snow moss. Snow moss means snow deposits in huge amount. Here, the water lilies give added beauty to the pond. These lines say how the casuarina tree gets attached, gets associated with the nature. Here comes the first half of the third stanza. The poet says that it is not because of the majestic appearance of the casuarina tree that is dear to her heart and soul. Magnificence means majestic appearance, dear means close. But the tree is dear to her because she has spent happy moments under it with her siblings. Beneath means under. Who are her siblings? Yes, Abju and Aru. Though years pass, she can't forget her sweet companions whom she loved with a deep love. Her sweet companions are her beloved siblings, Abju and Aru. For their sake, the tree is ever remembered. Here the tree is associated with Toru and her siblings. Now the continuation of the third stanza. The unforgettable memories of her siblings mixed with the images of the tree raise in her memory till the hot tears blind her eyes. Blent means mixed. When she is shedding tears in memory of her dead siblings, she could hear a dirge-like murmur. Dirge means sorrowful, murmur means whispering sound. Whispering sound, that is like the sound of the waves breaking on the shingle beach. Shingle beach means rocky beach or the beach with a lot of pebbles. What is that sound? It is the lament of the tree. An airy speech. Airy speech means a strange sound in the mysterious atmosphere. This strange sound can reach even the unknown land. When the poetess is shedding tears in memory of her dead siblings in a distant land, she could hear the painful cry of the tree for her absence in her native land. Here comes the fourth stanza. The first half of the fourth stanza is displayed on the screen. The memory of the tree touched the heart of the poetess. The person who has an eye of faith can see even the unknown thing as very well known, even in the distant land. Eye of faith means faith of seeing a thing in the imagination. Toradette has the eye of faith, so she can hear the wail of the tree. Wail of the tree means the painful cry of the tree, even in the distant land and sheltered bay. Distant land means very far off place. Sheltered bay means bay that can offer shelter. These lines say where she could hear the painful cry of the casuarina tree. Now the following lines say when she could hear the painful cry of the casuarina tree. She could hear the painful cry of the casuarina tree when the water wraith means unexpected appearance of water, which means huge water, is sleeping in the caves. Slumbering means sleeping in the caves, and when the gentle waves kissed means touched the classic shore of France and Italy. Classic shore of France and Italy means the beautiful shore of France and Italy under the moon at night. These lines, Toradette could hear the painful cry of the casuarina tree on the beautiful shore of France and Italy at night in her vision. This is the continuation of the fourth stanza. The poet describes the earth as tranced in a dreamless swoon. Tranced means hypnotized. Swoon means extreme emotion. The earth is silent and almost hypnotized due to strong dreamless emotion. This is nothing but Torudet's higher own state of mind also. When the earth is silent, when her mind is almost hypnotized by the emotional feelings for her siblings, she can hear the sound of the tree, which is like a music. Whenever the music grows, her inner eye would see a form sublime. Inner eye means inner mind, sublime means glorious. Whenever the music grows, her inner mind would see the glorious vision of the tree as she had seen in her happy childhood in her own loved native clime. Loved native clime means in her beloved motherland. How she had seen the tree in her motherland, that is in India, likewise, she sees the vision of the tree in the distant land of France. The tree connects her with her native land and with the memory of her dead siblings in this stanza. We come to the last stanza of the poem now. In this stanza, the poetess makes the tree immortal. Immortal means deathless. She eagerly immortalizes the tree here. Fain means eagerly. Consecrate means immortalize. She wants to present a lay in the honor of the tree. Lay means a mature, which means a thing that is done in an incompetent way. Here it refers to Torudet's priceless piece of poem. Thy means your, which means the casuarina tree here. She wants to dedicate a lay in honor of the tree. Why? Because it is the beloved of those who now in blessed sleep for I repose. Those means the beloved siblings of Torudet. I means yes, repose means rest in peace. Tree is dearer than life to her. It should be immortalized even after her days. Mayst thou be numbered, it should be immortalized. It should be immortalized even after her death with other deathless trees like the trees in Borrowdale. Borrowdale, a valley in the English Lake Districts in England. We come to the conclusion part of the poem now. Like those in Borrowdale is a literary allusion. William Wordsworth sings in praise of yew trees of Borrowdale in his poem Lawton Vale Yew Trees and makes the trees immortal. Even the above mentioned yew trees were to die, they would live on as anyone who read his poem and see them with their eye of faith. Likewise, Torudet wants to immortalize the casuarina tree by her poem. She wants to place the casuarina tree with the deathless trees like yew trees so that the unforgettable childhood memories with her siblings mixed with the images of the casuarina tree will linger pale under the branches of the immortalized casuarina tree forever. Linger pale means remind sleeping. In spite of fear, trembling hope, death the skeleton, time the shadow, the faint verses means the weak poem would sing the beauty of the casuarina tree repeatedly with eagerness. Rehearse means repeat. Her love for the tree would protect the tree from the curse, the forgetfulness. Defend means protect. Oblivion means forgetfulness. Thus Torudet immortalized the casuarina tree for the sake of her loved ones by writing a poem for it. This slide shows you the figures of speech applied in this poem. The figures of speech applied in this poem are zoomorphism, personification, simile, and symbolism. Go through the lines where the figures of speech applied. The figures of speech serve as ornaments and give added beauty to the poem. Hope you understand the poem and enjoy the poem. Thank you for watching this video lesson. Take care. Bye-bye.